Hi everyone, welcome and welcome back to Ras Aquaculture. I am Fatina and today I'm going to do a Q&A session called Fatina Answers, where I will answer all your questions regarding aquaculture, especially vertical mud crab farming and also indoor biofloc farming. Most of the questions are taken from the YouTube comment section to unravel your curiosities about aquaculture. Keep on watching. Thank you for watching. So let's jump straight away into the questions regarding recirculating aquaculture system, which is called RAS, RAS. So let's go to the crab farm. Hi everyone, so now we are at crab farm and I will answer your questions regarding RAS system. So let's move on to the question number one. Do you also provide RAS courses for freshwater fish farming? Interested if you have one beside the shrimp and mud crab? Unfortunately, no, we only conduct mud crab and shrimp farming course. Number two, do mud crab size affect grading? Yes, because each grades have different prices. Question number three, for 1,000 crabs capacity, how much land area needed? For 1,000 crabs like we have in RAS Aquaculture, 80 meters square or 800 square feet. Please check in the description box below on the floor plan link for the crab farming. Number four, what age can crab be harvested? Actually, it depends on the marketing. Either you want a small or a big crab. 80 gram crabs, usually with age like 3 to 4 months, can also be harvested. Depends on what size you want to harvest. Like I said, can be small or big. And last question, question number five. Do you provide a box for crabs? How much is the price for one box? Yes, we do. And it actually depends on what kind or what type of box that you want. Also depends on your business model, whether you do soft shell crabs production, fattening or others. So welcome back. We are at Bioflow right now and I'm going to jump into the questions regarding Bioflow system. So the first question is, what is the recommended water salinity for water plus vacuum packaging for shrimp? So we use the same salinity, which is about 10 ppt. Let me show you how the packaging looks. Number two, what's the shrimp production in 2,000 liters of RAS water? How many times can we harvest it in a year? First of all, we don't use RAS system for shrimp production. Instead, we use Bioflow system. So usually if the shrimp is about 20 grams, per cycle is 90 to 100 days. So in 1 year, at least 3 cycles. Question number three, do you use a Bioflow system for outdoor shrimp farming? For our pond-based shrimp farm, we do not use a full Bioflow system. It's a hybrid one. Fourth question, can you elaborate how the sand filter works and please say which microbes are we using in the Bioflow system? We do not use sand filters in the Bioflow system. Instead, we use a settling tank. Please check out our previous videos on how settling tanks works for more details. For the microbes used in the Bioflow system, we use Biomate, which is a product of us. You can check our videos on how we use Biomate too. The fifth question, from the culture pond, the water goes to the top of the settling tank or below the settling tank? Well, the water goes to the top and then the sheet will come out from the bottom to be discarded. You can check this video for more details on how the flock or sludge come out from the settling tank. And the last question regarding Bioflow system, is there any negative effect of too high dissolved oxygen level? Yes, but it's hard to get high dissolved oxygen level in the Bioflow process. That's all for Bioflow questions. And that's all for rust and Bioflow questions. Next, let's move on to the technical questions about farming. So, the first question we have is, how is the efficiency of the micro nano bubble? So, it actually depends on how you define efficiency. The nano bubble can obtain very high dissolved oxygen levels, but you have to weigh in the cost. Number two, does nano bubble really make a difference? Well, yes, there will be a difference, but have to look at the cost. Question number three, some say nanobubble or microbubble kills small bacteria. Does it disturb the process of plankton fermentation? No, actually, it does not disturb the process of plankton fermentation because we also use nanobubble and our Bioflow process is okay. Next, can we use MOS in open ponds? Yes, why not? Because it's the same as what you use in the indoor. Number five, how do you reduce alkalinity in your BFT tank? Alkalinity will naturally reduce in the BFT. If your alkalinity is increasing, so that means you have settlement. The last question regarding technical questions about farming is how to calculate water flow rate in pipes. So, you have to use a beaker and let the water from the pipe flows into the beaker and then you measure the time taken to obtain 1 liter. And that's all for today's Q&A session. If you have more questions that you would like us to answer, can leave it in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos like this, leave us a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Feel free to check out our free ebooks in the description box below. See you in the next video. Bye!